Good morning all. In my previous lecture, we have seen the equations of motion. So in this lecture, we are going to see the numericals in the rectilinear motion. So before entering into the numericals, we shall recall all the formulas which shall be used for the rectilinear motion. So we already knew that x or s means the distance traveled. So dx, ds means it is the displacement or the distance. And the time is denoted by t, and the velocity means change of displacement with respect to time, rate of change of displacement. So that means dx by dt or ds by dt, and acceleration means rate of change of velocity, that is dv by dt. So for the velocity, the unit is meter per second. For the acceleration, the unit is meter per second square. So here in this lecture video, we are going to see how to calculate that, how to calculate if some equations are given means. So in the example 1 of the rectilinear path, you can see the motion of a particle is given by the equation x is equal to t cube minus 3t square minus 9t plus 12. Determine the time, distance traveled, and the acceleration of a particle when velocity becomes 0. So they have given one equation and they are telling us to determine the time, distance traveled, and acceleration. So they are also giving a hint that when velocity is becoming 0. So now we shall see how to deal with this equation. So first, for the solution, just write down the same equation. And for the calculation convenience, see, actually we now we need to find the x distance. X means the distance traveled, and the time t we need to find, and finally acceleration a we need to find. So we have to find t, x and a. So take it as a equation number 1. First differentiate with respect to x. So if you differentiate dx by dt, that is the value of velocity v, right? So first differentiate this. If you differentiate this t cube, you will get 3t square, right? And minus this 3t square will become 6t, yes, minus 9t will become 9, and this 12, it is not having any t any notation, so it will become 0. So 3t square minus 6t minus 9, v is equal to, so you have differentiated this first equation. So they are saying the hint that when velocity is becoming 0, right? So just write down when v is equal to 0. Now you can watch the equation will become 3t square minus 6t minus 9 is equal to 0, because v value only we differentiated and kept, right? So this equation is looking like this form, ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0, right? So this can be resolved using, see, if you want the value of this t square, or this t means when it is equal to 0, you can apply this x is equal to plus or minus root of b square minus 4ac by 2a. So this equation you can use for finding the t. So finally, by using this equation with respect to this v is equal to 3t square minus 6t minus 9, you will get t as minus 1 or 3. So negative value of time cannot be taken into account. So consider only the positive value, that is t is equal to 3 seconds. So the fix that t is equal to 3 seconds. Yes, we have found that now. So if you substitute that t is equal to 3 seconds, you will get this x in the equation 1. So you will get x as minus 15 meter. It can be minus also, because the direction is maybe positive or negative, no problem. And finally, now you have this x and t. So again you differentiate the same equation, 3t square minus 6t minus 9. Y means acceleration a is equal to dv by dt. So if you just differentiate this 3t square minus 6t minus 9 means you will get 6t minus 6. Okay, so this 6t minus 6 means you need to substitute the value of t here. There finally you will get the acceleration as 12 meter per second square. The unit of acceleration is meter per second square. This is how you need to find the timing, distance and acceleration. So we have another one more numerical, we shall see it. So we shall see the numerical 2. A car is moving with a velocity of 15 meter per second. The car is brought to rest by applying brakes in 5 seconds. Determine retardation distance traveled by the car after applying the brakes. Right. So in this numerical, they are asking us to find retardation and distance traveled. Right. I already told you that you can use the equations of motion for the rectilinear numericals. As we discussed, like v is equal to u plus at and s is equal to ut plus half at square, and another one more v plus 2a u plus 2as, that three equations you can use at any cause. So whenever required, you can use all three equations of motion, right? So in this, they are asking you to find the retardation. So retardation means it is nothing but deacceleration or negative acceleration. Negative acceleration means it will be, see, acceleration will be in the positive, retardation will be in the negative manner, that's all. So how to find this retardation means same equations of motion only you should use, right? So they have given a car is moving with a velocity of 15 meter per second, means there is no initial velocity, it's already in the moving position only. So moving itself 15 meter per second, right? The car is brought to rest by applying brake, means the v will become zero when it is initial is 15 meter per second and final v is equal to zero, and they have given 5 seconds, means the time t is 5 seconds. So apply this three in the equation of motion, v is equal to u plus at. So finally you will get a is equal to minus 3 meter per second square. Yes, we have found retardation because the acceleration in negative value. This negative implies that it is deacceleration. And the second sub question is distance traveled by the car by applying the brake. So how to find the distance traveled means yes. Distance means yes. So for finding yes, you can use ut plus half at square, because we know that u is 15 meter per second and t is 5 seconds given in the question, and half is a means we have found that minus 3 meter per second square, and t timing is 5 seconds, that is given in the question. By substituting everything, you will get the s as 37.5 meter. So finally the distance travel is found. So in this question they were asking retardation and distance traveled. Through the equations of motion we have solved this. So in the rectilinear motion you will be having two different types of numericals. One will be like using the basic terms, like they will be asking you to find velocity, acceleration, displacement, like what the basic formulas I have taught you in the lecture video 1 of the 5th module. And in the next different types, in some numericals they will be asking you to find initial velocity, final velocity, distance traveled and all. That can be found using the equations of motion. We already seen the derivations of equations of motion. That same derivations, that same formulas you can use for finding the unknown things whichever they are asking in the question. So in my next lecture video we shall see about the curvilinear motion and projectile motion, and also motion under gravity. So thank you all.